अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 4 ऑफ आवर टेक्स्ट बुक, माय बैंक अकाउंट। एक्चुअली माय बैंक अकाउंट इज अ स्टोरी रिटन बाय स्टीफन ल्यूकॉक। स्टीफन ल्यूकॉक वाज अ फेमस कैनेडियन ह्यूमरिस्ट। आई हैव रिटन ऑन अ बोर्ड, फुल नेम इज स्टीफन बटलर ल्यूकॉक, कैनेडियन ह्यूमरिस्ट, एसेस्ट, टीचर, अ यूनिवर्सिटी प्रोफेसर, an historian. He was the famous writer. So this story of my bank account is a fictitious story. It's not a real story, it's a humorous story. So the chapter real name is My Financial Career, is the real name of a chapter. So I have written on a board, it's a fictitious and humorous story. Now this is a short story. So short story, before starting short story, we are going through the element of the short story that we read. Usually we read short stories, so short story has different element like character, setting of the story, dialogue and the conflict, climax and the falling action and the resolution. Now like characters, different characters in the story are setting. In this story, bank is a setting in which the story took place. And a conflict, any hurdle or any problem or any confusion with the characters, and climax, like the crucial point in the story, and that is called the climax. And falling action, turning point in the story, when the story become change, what happened in the story next, we become surprised, sudden change in the story, that is the turning point in the story, we call it the climax. And falling action, that is the turning point in the story. And the resolution, like the ending of the story, ending of the story is called resolution. So these are the basic element of the short story. And now let's start with the story. Before starting the story, one more point, writer use the first person narrative in the story, and writer use the personal pronoun I. Personal pronoun I and the first person narrative. First person narrative means writer introduced himself at the peak point of the mockery. He introduced himself. He just made a mockery of himself. Okay, so sometime we use first person narrative, sometime writer use third person narratives in the story. Third person narrative means when we are, you know, talking about other persons, and about other persons, that is like the third person, understand, regarding other person we are telling something to others, so that is third person. So this story format is in the first person narrative. Now when the story start, let's start with the textbook. When I go into bank, I get frightened. The clerk frightened me, the desk frightened me, the sight of the money frightened me, everything frightened me. The writer said when I entered the bank, everything frightened me. Writer became confused because he first time went in the bank and everything frightened him. Writer used the word first person narrative I, when I entered in the bank. Understand? So actually he was a professional man and he was a humorist, and this is a fictitious story. So writer said that when I entered in the bank, everything surprised me. I became confused. And the moment I pass through the door of a bank and attempt to do business there, I become a responsible fool. Writer became a responsible fool because he doesn't know what to do. And when the newcomers entered in the bank, he doesn't have any idea regarding anything, how to open an account, how to meet with the manager, these kind of thing, to whom we should discuss. So writer became confused. And so I walked unsteadily in and looked, turned at the clerk with fear. I had an idea that a person who was to open an account must necessarily consult the manager. Now the writer says, in order to open an account, we must consult with the manager first. The idea in the writer mind was that in order to open an account, we must meet with the manager first. So that was the misconception. Might be in the mind of the writer. Writer said that I want to meet with the manager.
in order to open my account. Why he wanted to open an account? There are reasons. If a person wanted to open an account, it might be an increment in the salary, or he want to save money in a bank. So there are so many reasons. Now let's see. I went up to the place marked accountant. The accountant was a tall, cool devil. The very sight of him frightened me. My voice sounded as if it came from the grave. Actually, writer, voice sounded as if it came from the grave, because he was feeling bank phobia, a fear of bank, fear of financial fear. These kinds of people are actually considered intelligent people, because they have a care of money. They don't want to lose anything. So writer had a bank phobia. Like when he entered in the bank, phobia means any kind of fear. Bank phobia means bank fear. Going into the bank and dealing with small matters actually is the fear in the mind. Some people have hydrophobia, like water phobia and height phobia. They have a fear in their mind going at height. So writer said, "Can I see the manager?" I said and added solemnly, "Alone." Now I don't know why I said alone. That word created a confusion in the mind of the reader. Writer said, why I said word alone, that I didn't know. I repeated it again. I said, alone, I want to see the manager alone. Means there is a personal information might be I want to share with the manager. And now manager also became confused. Now see, manager was a calm, serious man. I held my $56 prison together, pressed together in a ball in my pocket. Actually, writer's salary has been increased $50. Now, writer wanted to deposit $56 in a bank. So, because he has raised his salary at $50, there is an increment in salary, $50. Now, writer's salary becomes $56 at the present. So, it's increment $50. Now, writer wanted to deposit $56 in a bank account. So, he wanted to open an account and he wanted to deposit $56 in a bank. So he said that I want to meet with the manager alone. And can I see you? I asked alone. I didn't want to say alone again. But without this word, the question seemed useless. Writer said that I didn't want to say them again alone. Why I used alone word? But without the word alone, the question seemed to me useless. And now see, come in here, he said, and led the way to the private room. Then they went into the private room. Now the manager is discussing with the writer. Now let's see what manager thought. Manager thought that I was a detective. I knew what he was thinking and made me worse. No, not from Pinkerton. I said, coming to mean that I was from a rival agencies. When the manager saw the author, he said that, are you detective? आप कोई जासूस हैं? Are you from any agency? Are you a detective? Writer became confused, because when he used the word alone, manager realized that might be secret information he want to share, or any sort of thing that he want to share with me only. Any personal, any secret information he want to share only with me. So when the writer became confused and also manager became confused, they both became confused and looking at each other with anxiety. Now let's see, turn the page. To tell the truth, I went on, if something had urged me to tell lies about it, I am not detective at all. Writer made it clearly. Writer said, I am not detective at all. Now the manager seemed relaxed first. Later on, I have come to open an account. I tend to keep all my money in this bank. Now see the sentence. I intend to keep all my money in this bank. Others are funny. Now see, manager might be thinking he's a son of a rich man. Understand, he wanted to deposit all his money in my bank. It's a big account, might be a millionaire. So manager again became confused and relaxed a little bit. That is a big account and he wanted to deposit all his money in my bank. And now, because the sentence writer used, I want to deposit all my money in this bank. Understand, manager stood up and sat down. And he said, it's a big account, might be a son of Baron Rothschild, is a millionaire, and want to save all his money in my bank. Now see, a large account, I suppose, he said. Fairly large, writer said, a fairly large account, I whispered. I intend to now see, not what writer said, it made it clearly. I intend to place in this bank the sum of $56 now and $50 a month regularly. Now the secret came out. I intend to keep $56 in the bank. Writer ne sab bata diya, bhai main $56 apne bank mein jama karwana chahta hu aur har mahine jo hai $56 jama karwata rahunga. मैनेजर एकदम उठ गए वहाँ से, बिकॉज मैनेजर कुछ और ही समझ रहे थे कि कोई मिलियनर है, कोई बड़ा अकाउंट है, कोई एजेंसी का जासूस है, कुछ और है. बट द ईच एंड एवरीथिंग बिकम क्लियर नाउ द मैनेजर स्टूड अप, बिकॉज मैनेजर वॉज थिंकिंग समथिंग एल्स एंड राइटर डिस्कस समथिंग एल्स. अंडरस्टैंड? सो इट्स वेरी सरप्राइजिंग फॉर द मैनेजर. नाउ सी, मैनेजर सेड, मिस्टर मॉन्टगोमरी, ही सेड अनकाइंडली लाउड, this gentleman is opening an account, he placed $56 it. Good morning. Mr. Montgomery is the name of accountant. Ab dekhen writer kis tarah, manager kis tarah writer ki insult karta hai. Hame jab kisi ki insult karni hoti hai, hum bank mein kehte hain, bhai ye banda apna account khulwane ja raha hai, $56 apne account mein har mahine rakhega, iska account khol de jaldi. सबके सामने बड़ी आवाज़ में बोलता है ताकि लोग सुने कि ये कोई मिलियनर नहीं है, इसके पास सिर्फ $56 है जो अकाउंट में रखना चाहता है. और बड़ी आवाज़ में वो जो है उसे बोलता है, ही वांटेड टू डिपॉजिट $56 ओनली इन हिज अकाउंट, जस्ट ओपन दैट अकाउंट. सो मैनेजर स्टूड अप एंड ओपन द डोर. सो नाउ द रिमेनिंग पार्ट इंशाल्लाह आई डिस्कस इन माई सेकेंड लेक्चर. सो वी विल कंटिन्यू दिस स्टोरी एंड वी विल वाइंड अप दिस स्टोरी इन माई सेकेंड लेक्चर इंशाल्लाह. Thank you for listening.